Hey guys, my name's Stack, Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes, and this is a Dr. Aphra free-to-play farming rush. So most YouTubers, you know, they usually do like your traditional SLKR rush or Galactic Legend rush, but not me, because I'm different. Not a bad way. But I'm doing this because, you know, not many people do it. I thought it'd be a decent idea. It'd be fun to go back to, you know, the free-to-play days many years ago where it was like, wow, this is early game. Wow, look how much it changed. It's just drastic changes. I'm going to compliment CG for, like, probably the first time, like, ever. They really changed the new game, and they made it a lot better. Really, it's much easier as a new player to, like, you know, get the characters you want. So you might ask yourself, why Dr. Aphra? Why would you ever unlock or want to unlock Dr. Aphra? And my reasoning is going to be this. Crystals are in Grand Arena. And if you want crystals, you got to be good at Grand Arena. Who's a good Grand Arena team? Dr. Aphra. Dr. Aphra's Omicrons don't even have to be on for her to be good. She can still beat every single Galactic Legend outside of Grand Arena, which is huge for territory wars. And she's, I mean, Dark Side is not that hard of a territory battle, but if you decided, you know, I'm going to throw Dr. Aphra in territory battle, that works too. And it's not going to be, like, too difficult to unlock her. It's only 4 Relic 5s. Sana Staros is great. Hondo's okay. But BT and Trip are just great, especially with Dr. Aphra. You got 3/5 of the team. Now the question is, who's going to be that 4th and 5th? Well, the 4th's going to be Darth Vader. You get him practically for free. You get Darth Vader for free. And your 5th is going to be... Your 5th? I don't really know who the 5th's going to be, so let me know down in the comments, because I have no fucking clue. But also, she's easy to unlock, if I already said that. But most of her characters are easily farmable. So Starkiller, you know, you have, like, he's pretty easy to farm, he's accelerated, but all of his characters are high cantina nodes, like, but BT and Trip, they're, like, 2 light side and 3 dark side, like, that's it. Sana Staros and Hondo are both on the first 2, like, stages of cantina battles, and that's it, that's all you need. Relic 5 is not that much to ask for anyway, so that's what I'm going for. But along the way, you're going to need to start out with the beginner team. So what's my beginner team going to be? It's going to be Phoenix, like most other people. But instead of just, I'm just going to gear him up, 7 star him, probably gear him to like gear 7, unlock Emperor Palpatine to 7 stars, and then never touch them again. But I'm more on my strategy as the days go on. But let me know how you guys like this, and let's start off the series with day 1. Gotta throw a party for my day 1s. Ain't in the studio, but they'll lay some. So day 1 is arguably the most important day, because you have to start out this day on a good foot. You have to put your best foot forward to help your account in the end game. It really, like, sets you up for success if your day 1's good. So my goals for day 1 were pretty much just to unlock BT1's node, which was 2C light side hard. The thing is, my beginner team that is going to be Sortie with BT, Trip, and Sortie, just those 3, and then I'll get a 4th and 5th later. But all 3 of those are pretty easily farmable. So BT is the easiest one to get. So I started off, all right, on day 1, I'm going to try to get BT's node 3-starred and unlocked. So that's what I did, or at least attempted to do. The first one I needed was a good light side team, because, you know, the traditional free characters you get are just not very good. This is me grinding light side battles, but you don't get a good light side team from, like, the free characters they give you. So I needed a plan, and my plan was to unlock Hondo, who's neutral, who is also able to be used in both light side and dark side battles. So my first priority, as you can see from the footage, was to just 3-star Hondo's mission. After 3-starring his mission, I can then, you know, have him pretty much just carry me to BT's node. So I grinded Cantina battles, 3-starred his mission, and then spent a good amount of crystals refreshing it to unlock him day one at 2 stars. And I'm going to be honest, he's a beast low gear. As long as you have his, he has a unique ability where he gets plus 100% health steal. And that is really good because it helps you to stay alive during all these phases in the battle. So Hondo is definitely the first step. From there, after unlocking Hondo, you just got to do all the light side missions. They're so boring, but you just have to do them for the better of your account. Also, from doing all those Hondo missions, I was also able to get enough Cantina credits to unlock Chopper. Now, another problem for new and early players is leveling up, because you got to level up quickly to unlock stuff in the game. Like, level 40 is where you kind of want to be at the end of week 1, because then you can unlock Galactic War. Galactic War is huge because it pretty much means you have access to all Phoenix characters. So, Phoenix is going to be my starter team before Sortie. So it's going to go Phoenix, gearing up and unlocking, using Phoenix to unlock Palpatine. Then from there, I'm going to like keep farming Sortie, BT, and Trip, just like on their hard nodes. And then by the time I have them unlocked, I'll basically have Palpatine 7-starred and not going to need it. You know, play with my Phoenix anymore. I can just discard them like I already used them. And so the point of Phoenix is they're great early team. They help you in Galactic War. They're really easy for that. They're good arena team. And the higher up in arena you go is important because arena, squad arena, is where you can get some Kanan shards. And Kanan shards are really important because, you know, he's part of the Phoenix. The other two characters that I haven't mentioned yet. Actually, 3. Garzeb, or Zeb, the guy with the big stick thing. He is from in the Galactic War store. So he's probably going to be the Lax Phoenix you unlock. And then Hera and Ezra are both Cantina battle nodes. So they're going to be pretty easy to unlock. And, I mean, I've already recorded Day 7. I just haven't done a voiceover. And, yeah, I had the whole Phoenix team unlocked within a week. Also, by doing journey guides, you get 50 crystals, which you can use towards Cantina refreshes or hard node refreshes, whatever you want. But main thing, day one, was to just unlock BT's node. It was real hard. It was tough, but, you know, I was able to do it. It took a really long time, like probably an hour and 30 minutes of footage. And some of it I didn't even record. I just didn't record some of it because it was just so boring. It was just me clicking auto pretty much. But besides that, another important thing that CG added to help new players out was a new player calendar. And there was like a new player data card. You probably already saw it in my footage, but basically it's a data pack or card, whatever. It's a pack in the store. Gives you 2,000 energy and I think it was 9,000 sim tickets, which is so helpful in the early game because your sim tickets are huge to save time. Without these sim tickets, I would have had to done so much more work to just unlock Hondo. I would have had to done all the battles instead of just simming them. And it's huge. So props to CG on that. You also get this new player calendar, which gives you XP, and that helps you to really, you know, build levels up early and quickly. Another thing that really helps, or like another good farming thing that it just helped, like it was just convenience, was the Mandalorian had like this thing in the events where I could just get all the Mandalorian characters for free. Like it was a marquee event that happened like later. So I was able to unlock Mando, Grief, Queel, Cara Dune, and IG-11, who are all great. IG-11 is particularly great because he's a droid and I'd be able to use him in conjunction with Sortie, BT, and Trip, as like maybe a possible 4th. So, as I said earlier, the main goal of this farming guide is to just unlock Dr. Aphra as quick as possible. She's great in Grand Arena, she's good outside of Grand Arena, and, you know, she's just great all around. And that's why, you know, I'm trying to unlock her. Also, it's never been done before. So it's another thing that I'm trying to pioneer Galaxy of Heroes farming. So it takes, I'm stuttering, but I think it's going to take about 5 months maybe to unlock Dr. Aphra, and then you have a character that beats every single Galactic Legend, except Jedi Master Kenobi, but with Cat, but like, there's no non-Galactic Legend counter to that. Like, people that do an SLKR rush will get countered by Dr. Aphra, because Dr. Aphra beats SLKR. You're not going to have anything to deal with your Sana Staros, which is on defense, who's also really solid. I haven't mentioned her yet, but I'm not going to plan on getting her until I'm at least level 85, because she needs a Zeta to get, like, the cooldown reduction thing, so, like, Cara Dune can just spawn or spam her, grenade attack. So you need a Zeta for that. Sorority, I think, also needs a Zeta, but it's not as vital and important as BT's is. So, Hondo. He's another one of the characters that I'm farming up for this. Hondo's great because he's great in the early game. He's not great in late game, but he's good in the early game for just getting you through those first day, that first week where you need for light side battles. And then later on, maybe I'll put him in like a scoundrel team. I don't really know what the plan for Hondo is. Also, ships. Ships is going to be a problem because none of Dr. Aphra's requirements have ships. So maybe I'm going to plan on maybe getting either an Executor, but I think after Dr. Aphra, I might go for Jedi Knight Luke. So maybe I'll get a Rebel fleet along the way. We'll have to see how things pan out. But this is a new approach. I think it'll be nice to watch, but I really hope that, you know, you guys enjoy this new series. You like, you know, the way things are going. You enjoy the possibility that it brings, and just it differentiates itself. So that was day one. Did a lot of beginner stuff. Did my dailies. And most importantly, unlocked BT1, 3 stars node, which was important because it allowed me to, farm his shards. And then once I unlock him, that's going to be him, Trip, and Sorority are going to be the 3 characters I'm going to put majority of my resources into. And they're probably going to be my first Relic 5, which is just going to cross off that Dr. Aphra. Like, basically, that's 50% of Dr. Aphra done. Then from them, I'm going to go to Sana, R5 her, probably bring up Stormtrooper Han, Kara, and then hopefully I'll have Rolo and Sholo by then. I don't know about that, but that's questionable. But day one, really important to get yourself on the right foot. I didn't unlock Hera's node day one, but I unlocked it day two. But if you really have the time to do it, like, I have a life, so I didn't have the time to do it. But if you don't have a life and you have time to do it, then by all means, go and do that. Go and 3-star Hera's node. And also my second major thing of advice, just going for the whole series, is to use your crystals on Cantina refreshes, which are huge for helping you unlock characters. My Cantina refreshes helped me basically 5-star Ezra in a matter of a week. You'll see later on. I'm hoping to post, day 2 to 8 or like a week, like worth of days, probably in a week from now, but stay tuned for that, and peace. Y'all don't wanna hear me, you just wanna dance.